Hello everyone, my name is Robert and welcome to my second Q&A. Before starting answering your questions, I want to make one announcement and ask you two questions. The announcement is that I started a Patreon, so if you want to help me with the channel, just go to the link in the description. The first question is, should I start making a second channel about gas masks and surplus stuff? Everything you can see around me. And the second question would be, should I try playing other games that come close to the stalker atmosphere, stalker gameplay like Metro, Fallout, rip-off games made after Stalker like Stay Out or Survivium? Let me know in the comments. So I'll begin answering your questions, and I'll start with a very wholesome question from you guys, from Damian. How are you? I'm good, thanks for asking. Who is your favorite named stalker from any faction? My favorite stalker would be either Scar, the main protagonist of Clear Sky, which is actually a mercenary, but I don't know, it's a big discussion about that. Or if I have to choose another one, would be Nimble, who was also part of Clear Sky, and it's a loner in Shadow of Chernobyl and in Call of Pripyat. Why did you name your YouTube channel Stalker Experience, and what made you to start a YouTube channel? What made me to start a YouTube channel? Well, it was firstly out of passion for the games, because I've played them for years already and I knew a lot of stuff, stashes, lore, information, hidden secrets and stuff like that, and there were no people making videos about that. But the only exception being AL Gaming, who had some very nice videos about the in-game lore, but I found that not being enough for me. And the name Stalker Experience, I don't know. My experience with Stalker, that's it. Your opinion on Stalker Online, it's shit. It sucks, I don't like it. I tried it for an hour or something and I just uninstalled it. A question from my friend Vanya Important, check out his channel, he has some very good content. What are the future plans for the channel? What content can we expect? Future plans, I don't know, I want to live stream at least 2 times a week and post 1 video a week, at least as I don't have a full-time job. Because of the coronavirus and everything that happened, I've lost my job, so I have a lot of free time, so that's why I started making a lot more content than usual. And about what content can we expect, I'll be more working about the cosplay videos and of course the lore videos. I don't know, I have some ideas, but I'll keep them secret and you'll see if I will start working on those ideas. When are you going to overthrow the Romanian government? And airsoft video when? Overthrow what? Come on, man. If you're from Romania, you know the situation. We're in deep shit, and without the Second Amendment, that would be pretty hard to do here. And an airsoft video? When? What do you mean an airsoft video? You mean reviewing airsoft replicas or a field video? As you know, at this moment you can't go to any airsoft fields because you can't go outside, basically. I don't go so often that airsoft fields. I don't know, people there are extremely cringy and it's full of boomers. What's your favorite location in Stalker, and what is rarest location what have you been explored? And what is your favorite shotgun in Stalker? My favorite location, it's in Cordon. It's the birthplace of any Stalker, and it's, I don't know, I just like the atmosphere, and I think it's the area that I know like the back of my hand. And the places that I explored, Vles, I think it's Yantar, and Red Forest, I find them extremely scary, and I mean the atmosphere gives me a lot of anxiety, let's say, and usually when I have to go through Red Forest or Yantar, I just do my quest and get the fuck out of that place. Oh, and about the shotguns, if we are talking about vanilla Stalker games, I like the Toz shotgun, especially with the slug shells. And if we are talking about mods, I like the Saiga 12. That's a lot of firepower. What ending did you get in your first shot of Chernobyl playthrough? Oh, of course, I got the I want to be rich ending. It's the most encountered ending for everyone. What is your favorite stalker game or mod? My favorite vanilla stalker game would be Shadow of Chernobyl, and my favorite mod so far, besides Autumn Aurora 2, it's either Call of Chernobyl or Oblivion Lost Remake 2.5 at this point. Maybe I'll try something new. And what if GSC can buy the Hunk character, a character from a Resident Evil game series from Capcom? I've heard about Resident Evil but never played any of them, so I can't answer your question. Sorry. How would you describe Stalker series with the shortest amount of words possible? Unforeseen consequences. Your favorite faction? I like the Loners, even though I don't consider them a faction. But if I have to choose a second favorite, it would be Duty. Are you looking forward to the True Stalker mod? It will be a story mod translated by Sasha the Red. I haven't heard about it, I'll check it out, and if it's interesting, yeah, definitely, I always like to try new stories. Have you seen the latest news on Dead Air December 2019, and what's your opinion on the mod? No, I haven't seen the last news on Dead Air. I'm not a huge fan of Dead Air, Misery and Anomaly, but I'll definitely play them more in the future. And Dead Air, it's one of my favorite between these three. Yeah, I'll check the news. I really don't know what's happening. I'm not the type of stalker fan that is checking MattDB every day. I don't know, I just go there when I want to try a new mod or I want to play a mod that I used to play and I have to download it again. Are you still gay? I don't know, ask your mother. Can I play with you sometime on multiplayer? Yes, of course, every time I livestream a multiplayer session you can join. If you saw any of those live streams, you can see that I always share the information of the server that I'm playing on. So yeah, you're welcome, why not? Face reveal. What do you mean face reveal? This is my face. I mean, I can take this off, but it's the same face. What currently unreleased stalker mod are you most looking forward to? There's basically two mods that I can't really wait to play them. One of them being Ray of Hope, but I think all hope is lost for that mod.
Why are we still here? Just to suffer every night.
And the second mod will be the XRMP or something like that. I don't really know the name for it. It's the one that I played with Nikolai and Papa Kiev about the base defense, because they are planning to do a co-op mod, a cooperative mod, in which I think you'll be able to play with some friends the story mod, which would be amazing. It's literally my dream since I started playing stalker games. Why do mercenaries attack Freedom in Dark Valley, Stalker Clear Sky? Why do you ask me? Do I look like a mercenary? Ask them, for fuck's sake. Your opinion on Call of Chernobyl or Anomaly? I really like Call of Chernobyl. I think I find it the final frontier of the stalker games after you finished all of them, and with some mods and you're pretty experienced, you should jump right in Call of Chernobyl. And Anomaly, I played it for a while, but I'm not a big fan of it. I don't like the inventory and the fact that you have thousands and thousands of items that are pretty much useless and you can live without them if you have a decent amount of money. But in general, I like it. I think it's a little bit overrated. I will try it again. Maybe I'll change my opinion, and of course I'll live stream it. It's not a bad mod though. Dragunov or PSL? Unfortunately, because of the rules and the laws in my country, you are not able to get any firearms, and actually can get some, but it's extremely hard and pointless and extremely expensive. I don't know, if you are talking about aesthetics, I like them both equally, but if you are talking about performances and stuff like that, my opinion is pointless. I think I've never played any video games that have the PS, only the Dragon. What's your favorite mutant in Real Stalker, Call of Pripyat and Vanilla Mon? What the fuck? Real Stalker, Call of Pripyat or Vanilla Mon? Anyway, if you're talking about the Vanilla Call of Pripyat, I'd go with either the Snork or the Bloodsuckers. In my opinion, those are the most terrifying mutants in the game, especially the Snark, because it seems so realistic though. Do you know anyone who has memories of the Chernobyl incident? Have they ever talked about it? What did they tell you? Yes, of course, since my parents were born in the 70s, they were in their... they were almost teenagers in the 80s, and my father and my mother told me that there was a little bit of panic, but not that much, because, you know, communism and a lot of stuff was hidden. They were prohibited to go to school, to work for a few days, and they had to take iodine pills, and that's the most of it. They were a bit afraid. They were more afraid of the... This is from my grandparents. They were a bit more afraid about the Cuban Missile Crisis than the Chernobyl incident. So that's basically it. Everyone from Romania, when they're asked about the Chernobyl incident, they'll take the same thing. Prohibited to go to work and school and taking iodine pills. Oh, and not eating fresh fruits or vegetables from your yard or from the marketplace. They might be contaminated. Have you ever played a Gmod Stalker? If so, did you like it? If you're talking about Gmod roleplaying, no, I haven't. I used to have Gmod on my older Steam account that I've lost some time ago, but I've never went actually on any server. I just liked to do my stuff alone. So no, I didn't play any Stalker roleplay on Gmod. Your favorite faction? Loner. If not loner, duty. Duty or freedom? Duty. Who is your favorite trader? I'd go with the beard from Call of Pripyat. Will I get unbanned on Discord of Chernobyl? What the fuck? Why is Stalker series your favorite game and how it inspired you to make this channel? I don't know, it's more like a passion, the game series, the Stalker game series. I like a lot of games, like the Battlefield franchise, the Call of Duty franchise until some point, the GTA franchise, I've played them for a lot of time, Metro, let's say, recently, but the Stalker, it's inside here, inside my heart. I have so many memories with it, I corrupted so many people to play it and enjoy it as I do, and I don't know, it's also very relatable because it has so much that I can see in my country, like architecture, vehicles, outfits and stuff like that. And the same, I think it's the same thing that will answer a Ukrainian or Russian or someone in general from the Eastern Europe and an ex-communist country. It has a familiar feeling or something like that. And I like the fact that it's the best combination between a realistic game with a little bit of sci-fi, I mean the mutants and all of the anomalies. They are believable in my opinion. I mean, they look and their stories and the lore behind them sounds like, yeah, these things can really happen in real life, and I like that. And what inspired you to make this channel? There was a big lack of Stalker content, in my opinion, on YouTube about cosplay, about lore, besides the AL Gaming channel. And one thing that inspired me to do this was the Russian and Ukrainian channels. I usually watched their videos, never understanding a word out of their videos, but they looked very interesting, and I was like, why shouldn't I try doing this myself? And that's basically it. What's your favorite Stalker mod? For Shadow of Chernobyl it would be Automata 2, for Clear Sky it would be Arsenal Overhaul, and for Call of Pripyat I don't have a favorite one yet. Why did you create this channel? What made you make this channel? As I said previously, there was AL Gaming that inspired me to do something similar, but not copying his stuff. That's why I don't make lore videos about factions. I highly recommend watch his videos about factions. Second of all, I was inspired by the Russian channels to try doing it myself. I mean, I've watched some of their videos. I can't watch them till the end because I don't understand anything just I just understand because of the video itself, but not what the creator says in the video. And that pissed me off really hard, and I wanted to make it for anyone that could understand English from Western Europe, the Baltics, the United States. Most of my viewers are from the United States, Canada and United Kingdom, so yeah. What city you live in? I live in Bucharest, the capital of Romania. How many hours do you have on the Stalker franchise? Well, if you see my Steam library right now, there are rookie numbers like less than a week for all the Stalker games. But you can trust me, I played these games since 2009 or something like that. I've always had them installed on my computer or my laptop. They are usually the first games that I install, so I have not hours but years playing this game. I used to have them on an older Steam account, and I had only Stalker bought on that account, and Gmod and something like the Half-Life franchise. And when I started the YouTube channel, I wanted to make a new Steam account with almost the same games and a few more other, and that's it. So as a conclusion, I have years playing it, but Steam doesn't show it because I have a totally different background. And I'll be honest, the first time when I played them, I got them from Pirate Bay. I was a little kid, I didn't have money at all to buy them. Who is the best? Duty or Freedom? And why Freedom? A very interesting question from Prepared Hawks. Also check out their channel. Considering the growing success and popularity of the Stalker franchise in the West, do you think that GSC will put more foreign Stalkers in Stalker 2? Foreign as in not Ukrainian, Russian, Belarusian. Considering that we have the Mercenary faction that is basically made of people from around the world. And the second thing is that most of the people have their face covered either with a gas mask or a balaclava or something like that. It's not that important, maybe the language, but in the end I don't think it really matters. Maybe the only thing that could be changed would be to have females in the game, which also in my opinion doesn't really matter because they will have their faces covered with gas mask and other stuff. So I don't think it really matters if we have people from Chile or Hong Kong in the zone. Everyone will have the same fate probably. Is anomaly related to blowout? What do you mean anomalies if are related to blowout? As far as I know, they change their places after any blowout. Does Freedom have good weed? Which people should do a Stalker fan movie project together? This is a very old question, I might say. Preferably people from the same country that have enough equipment and airsoft or real weapons, a little budget, let's say, and a lot of free time and equipment. I don't know, I mean, there is a lot of cosplayers in the Western Europe and United States, but they are divided because they live in different countries or different states. And I think the best at this thing would be either the Ukrainians or the Russians. And I highly recommend to watch the the photograph fan video. It has like 30 minutes, and it's the best Stalker fan film that I ever seen until this point. I'll leave a link in the description. A very good question from Samuel. Is there any mod that was so frustrating that you didn't finish it? Yes, of course. Lost Alpha was one of the most frustrating mods that I've ever played. Extremely buggy and extremely boring at some point. he says that if you saw my video about Radiophobia 2, that is another frustrating mod because it has a lot of bugs and a lot of crashes. And I might say Misery sometimes, but Lost Arcade is one of the most frustrating mods. Oh, and also another Nesunyanka, that mod is completely retarded. What do you expect to see back in Stalker 2? That's a big question with a short question with a big answer. I'd like to see the same factions. I'd like to see Scar back. I don't really care about Strelok, but I want to see Scar back. Nimble also, Sidorovich, I'd like to see. I mean, some of the important characters from the previous games I'd like to see. I'd like to see a big open map without any loading screens, but if they will have loading screens, it won't be a big problem. I'd like to see a physical copy of it. The same anomalies, I hope there will not be huge changes that will make the game extremely different from the three others. I mean, what I really appreciated about Stalker is that if you play Shadow of Chernobyl, you know how to play Clear Sky and Call of Pripyat without making a training or something like that. I'd like to see the same thing in the upcoming Stalker, even though it will be on a totally different engine. I'd like to see the same atmosphere, the same music, the same specific music in every area of the game, the same mutants, and I'd like to see new mutants, but that would be the same realistic as the previous ones were, made out of experiments or anomalies or something like that. I'd like to see more weapon customization. I'd like to see vehicles, to be honest, if the map will be big, but not broken vehicles as we have in the mods, Lost Alpha or other mods. And I'd like to see, this is the most thing, that this is the thing that I'd love to see, and I hope they will introduce this, a cooperative option to play with a friend or to play the story mode or a sandbox or something like that. I'd really like to see that. This was the last question. There were very interesting questions, very nice questions. Also, I wanted to make this for 1.5k subscribers, but I had other videos to work on. And it's more for 2k subscribers. So thank you a lot for subscribing. Thank you a lot for all of the nice words that you write down under all of my videos. So see you next time. Check out my Patreon if you want to help me. The link is in the description. But until then, good hunting, stalkers.